week on the bench, I'm going to tie you up the Chinook Muddler. The Chinook Muddler is exactly the same as any other normal muddler, the only difference being the steelhead hook. You need extra sturdy hooks for these big fish. Make sure you have this list of materials before you start tying the fly. For the hook, we're going to use a Mustad R90 steelhead, size 2-4. We'll use black 6-0 thread to tie with. We'll use some large copper mylar tinsel for the body, some turkey for the tail, some heavy copper wire for the rib. For the first wing, we'll use some natural bucktail. For the second wing, we'll use some turkey. And for the head, we'll tie it with natural caribou. To start the fly off, I'm going to take my thread and again form a nice base layer, as we do in all our patterns, and take it right back to the bend in the hook. For the tail, I'm going to take some natural turkey and I'm just going to run it back so it's past the bend in the hook and tie that in for the tail, and take a few wraps behind the turkey on the tail just to help that tail stand up a little bit and trim off your excess. Now the tail's tied in, I'm going to take some heavy copper wire and tie it in. This is going to rib up the body a little bit later once I tie it in, but make sure you lay it down and get a good foundation of thread over top of that wire. For the body, I'm going to take some copper tinsel and tie it in at the butt of the hook. Move my thread forward to about 3/4 up the hook, and then I'm going to tie this in to make sure that the copper color is exposed for the body, and wrap it forward to the eyelet to form the body. The next step is to take that heavy copper wire we had off the back and take about 6 or 7 turns up the body to segment the fly until we get about 3/4 of the way up the hook and tie off. To tie on the first wing, I've taken some strands of natural bucktail, a fairly decent clump, and I'm going to extend this back so it's almost the length of the tail, not quite past the tail, but almost the length of the tail, and tie it near the head and trim off the excess and allow that hair to flare a little bit to form a nice underwing. To form the second wing, I'm going to take a nice thick strand of my turkey and make it quite thick, because what I'm going to do is put it on the fly and then kind of double wrap it over my first wing. So it's kind of covering the first wing a little bit, and this gives a real nice profile on the fly and adds a second wing to the fly. And tie it in and snip off your excess. To start the head off, I'm going to take a clump of caribou, and to start the first segment off, I'm going to form a small collar on the fly. I'm going to put this caribou back so it's about half the length of the hook, allow it to roll around the hook slightly, and then pull it really tight. So I actually am forming a collar on the fly along with the first segment of head. And then we're going to push this back, pull it all back, and bring our thread forward. And continue this process all the way up the fly, wrapping more and more caribou in as we go to form our nice bushy head on the fly. Now that I've spun the caribou all the way up to the eyelet, I like to leave a little bit of space at the head. I don't like to spin it right to the eyelet, because these are what I call an inverted hook. The eyelet is actually points up a little bit. So I'm going to leave just a little bit of room and just enough room to whip finish off the fly at this point. So whip finish off the thread and cut off your thread so you're ready to start trimming. To finish the fly off, we have to trim the head to the proper size. So I've taken the fly out of the vise, and I'm going to obviously do this over a garbage can because it's very messy. And we're going to start trimming the fly down, trimming the head down. You want this head to be fairly sparse. It is going to be fairly sparse with hair, but keep it fairly big. We want this to be a nice big fly. And keep trimming down until you have a nice bullet head formed on the fly. And there it is, the finished Chinook Muddler. You know, the nice thing is to be able to go Chinook fishing. The unfortunate thing is you're going to probably burn through about 30 or 40 of these flies a day, because they are tackle busters.